Yes, class 10th D. We're going to revise chapter 1, letter to God. Some points are written here and further more points you'll be noting down. Fine. Story of a hardworking farmer. This is the beginning. Protagonist of the story is Linko the farmer. He is very hardworking. This is one of the, you can say, trait of his personality. He's very hardworking. And another feature, you can say another trait of his personality is very innocent, utterly, sheerly innocent man who believes in God. He has unshaken or firm faith in God, blind follower of God. Fine. He believes in God to that extent. So this is the character sketch of our protagonist. Then he, in the beginning of the chapter, we get to know that he is expecting a good harvest because he has put in a lot of efforts. Last boy, I can see you talking to the other boy. So he is expecting a good harvest. After putting in efforts, everybody expect output in that good way. Fine. When you put in efforts for during your exams, then you expect results. Lekin result mein wahan pe red pen se cross baje hote hain, then you start crying. Yeah, I have put in efforts. I studied for 12 hours a day. Fine, जो पढ़ता ही नहीं था वो marks लेके जा रहा है. In that way you feel bad. So similarly, here after putting in so many efforts, he was waiting for rain. When rain started, he was so happy, elated. By putting your heads down, you cannot, you know, save yourself. I guess. मन्नत सीधा हो. सीधे होके बैठी. So then he was expecting a good harvest, but rain turned into hailstorm, which destroyed his crops. And he was dejected. He was sad. He was in utter gloom. Fine. Then, as he has unshaken faith in God, he thought, God is responsible for this thing. Whatever happens in anyone's life is just because of God. So he decides to write a letter to God. Clear? So then now, I will be calling name. That child will give me the next point. Fine? Mitanshu. Tell me, when Lenko decides to write a letter to God, what was the content of the letter? What he writes in the letter? First letter, yes. What does he demand in the letter? Nobody will speak. The one who speaks is going to get the most toughest version. That don't give him hint. Do not listen to others. You have already ask for money. How much? 100 pesos. When that was the currency. Better. So, he writes a letter to God and he asks for money, obviously. He thought that this much money, he neither asked more. Whatever was required for his survival, growing the crops again, and by the time he gets the output, he could survive with his family. So he demands 100 pesos. Fine. He writes a letter. He goes to the post office, puts a stamp over it, puts the letter in the box over there. That shows firm faith in God. Clear? And then postman and postmaster. Two more characters are coming here. Clear? Then what happens? Postman, firstly, he has a hearty laugh. He starts laughing. Who starts laughing? Yes, please listen carefully. And the ones, those who are not, they are going to answer the questions. Then I'm observing everything. I'll be giving you questions also, subjective types. So postman has a hearty laugh because he thought they have never received a letter which is addressed to God. That was the reason. So when he, after that, postmaster also gets engrossed into it. So, but when postmaster now, he was very genuine persona, kind-hearted, generous. Fine. He was slim or amiable or fat or amiable. So that was the question yesterday. Fat and amiable man. Amiable is very loving persona. Fine. Very loving. So he was there. He thought that this man has unshaken faith in God. If he does not receive money, his faith will be shaken. I do not want this man. I do not want this boy to be sitting there. Why are you talking again and again? I have to see your name. Rest of the like commentary boys, you are will be giving chance. I'll be giving you 5 minutes at the end. You can speak then. ठीक है, इतना पता नहीं क्या बोलना होता है आपको. So he decides, the postman decides that we should not break his faith and we should collect money. And he was the one who had that idea. Who collects post office money? All the employees. So that was his idea. Everybody paid off some part of their salary. He could collect how many pesos? 70 pesos he could collect, put in the envelope, signed as God and sent it there. When Lenko received the letter, now that was the question again yesterday. Was he happy, sad, dejected? What was the answer? He was angry. Angry is the correct answer. Rather than being sad, he was so angry. And upon whom he was angry? On God? No, he was angry about post office employees. He thought God cannot cheat because he is very innocent, number one, and he has unshaken faith. He thought God cannot cheat me. These bunch of crooks have cheated me. Bunch of crooks here are post office employees. Fine. So he decides on his own that this thing is done by post office. Now, what did we learn out of it? Somebody who have helped you, they are being called bunch of crooks. There is another theme hidden in this chapter. What do you think it is? Raise your hand and speak. Yes, Princy. Humans do not have trust on each other. What else? Yes? Not being grateful. Yes. This is the exact option. We are not grateful for what we have. Number one, we are not grateful toward other human beings. And yes, when we do not trust others also easily. If one person is wrong, doesn't mean the whole world is wrong. There are genuine people also. So another theme is lack of trust. Fine, amongst us. Lack of belief on others. Others can also help us. Fine. And one more theme is one should not be innocent to that extent that you start seeming to be a foolish person. Lencho was not able to recognize actually who helped him. Fine. He was so blind in that faith that rather than being grateful and applying his logical thinking that who could help me, he started calling them bunch of crooks. Fine. So when he opened the envelope, he got 70 pesos. Now, yes, Ryan, tell me, after that, what does farmer decide to do when he was not happy, was angry? Yes. What does he decide after that? Banu, please help him. You can speak the answer. Sit down. Keep sitting. Enjoy yourself. You were not paying attention to the question. Don't disturb others, please. Yes, Parikshit, Gitanshu. Why are you involved there? This is the problem. Yes, my question is, what was decided by the farmer when he was angry after opening the envelope? What was the decision he made?
He decided to write.
And what he wanted to write in that? Yes, very good. Sit down. So he asked for 30 more pesos. In the second letter, he asked for more money, that is 30 pesos, and he called the post office employees bunch of crooks in the second letter. Clears? Note to send it by? Yes, that was also the part of second letter. Very good. So he said that he asked also to send the money directly to him rather than sending by these people. So that is innocence of the farmer, unshaken faith of him. So a letter to God ends there only. Sometimes, another theme is sometimes we misunderstand other people. Preconceived notions about others. Fine. We think always by keeping, presumed things in our mind are there. Okay, this person is not good. We have presumptions about others. प्रिज्यूम करना पहले, प्री मतलब पहले, अज्यूम, presumptions, fine, that we put assumptions in our mind, ki, okay, this person is not good, this person is bad, this is good, these are the presumptions without any reason. Yes, Parikshit, please pay attention. Now I will be one thing I missed in the chapter. Yes, Navya, stand up. Describe the location of Lencho's house. Top of a low hill. Fine, sit down. In the beginning, farmer has mentioned that there is one only thing the earth needs. What is that thing? Yes, Tanya. Downpour of rain. Very good. So I'll be asking quickly. Those who are listening, they will be answering. Those who are just sitting in a dumb way without even considering the questions, that is your loss. What had Lencho predicted and did this prediction come true? Yes. Firstly, tell me what he has predicted. Fate. Dakshita, stand and speak. Yes. He predicted good downpour or shower? No. It is something else. We'll see to it. You consider others and we'll see to it. Morphology is the heading for that. Okay, you leave that, then rest of the things completed. Biochart setting. Wait. Fine, we'll discuss this thing later, okay? If you have any doubt, Mehak can ask you, only two students now online. You can write in the chat box, okay? Regarding this chapter. Yes, my question is, so we were discussing about a prediction. He actually predicted it would rain, but looking towards the northeast. So you can get any MCQ, northeast, southeast, in that way you'll be confused. Yes, I'm just saying even direction can come. So he was predicting from northeast side, fine. So yes, it did come true from the same direction. Rain downpour started pouring in. Fine. So this is the answer. Next is, what did the farmer say about the raindrops? Chahat, can you answer this? What did he say about... Your name is Chahat? What did farmer say about raindrops? What? This is very vague, silver coin. Speak the complete sentence. Farina. Wrong answer. This is Peta. This is not the way to answer. Parina is going to answer it. Please let her speak. Yes. He compared the raindrops with the cents. Firstly, big drops with 10 cents, small drops with 5 cents. He considered all the drops very precious. Now you stand up and leave the class immediately. Yes, Gitanshu ke piche. Leave the class, please. And the ones who are commenting can join him. Do you think this is the way? If one person is giving answer, you are supposed to listen. Aapke jaise log hi hote hain, fir MCQs mein cheating karte hain jo. Because they do not listen in the class. Examination hall may you keep on calling others. Anyone who's going to speak, please go out. Maximum questions we have to cover up when we finish one chapter. This is our purpose. Again, I can see many faces. Next is, what did the boys collect What did the boys collect in this chapter? Wait, frozen pearls? What pearls? You have to tell that also. Yes, Tanya, explain it. Frozen pearls or? Yes. Hailstorm began when boys started collecting big chunks of ice, that is frozen pearls, right? Next is, why and how? You got a question of Locustus yesterday only. So question is, why and how did Lencho compare the hail to a plague of locusts? Yes, Bissam, very good. Nobody is listening to him. The most important question. Yes. Yes. Very good. So impact of plague of locusts is very devastating. Locusts eat away most of the leaves and corn. Fine. And impact of the hail was even deadlier than that. So he compared it. Clear? It destroyed everything. Hailstorm destroyed trees, crops, leaves, flowers. Nothing was left. When locusts is there, there will be some leaves will be eaten up by them, fine, but something will be left. Why hailstorm is deadlier? Because it destroyed the crop itself, leaves itself, trees itself. So everything was destroyed by hailstorm. That's why he called it more deadlier than plague of locusts. Next is, did Lenko show a surprise on seeing the money? Parikshit, answer this. Stand up. Now nobody will raise hand. I will name the child. That person will speak. And the one who gives him hint will be the next to answer. Yes. Question is, did Lenko show a slight surprise after receiving the money or not? Yes. Explain it. He got angry. Okay, bad job. Yes, this girl, please tell me the same question. You, with Raina, you are sitting. What's your name? Arlene. Yes, answer this question. Now you will ask me to, can you repeat the question? I will not. Already twice I spoke the question and you people are not paying attention. Only this is the class where I'm shouting while teaching. Hanji, Isha Preet ji, bolo. Yes, he was not surprised. He had already unshaken faith in God. He already expected that God will answer him. Sit down, please. Next is, voice na karo Isha Preet, what are you doing? Yes, beta. I guess all the questions are covered. I'm just searching if anything new. So, beta, last question. Everything is covered. Last question is open-ended one. Whatever you want to speak, please stand up. Anji, punishment is not given. Fine. So, let it be an answer only. What is the message of this story? We will be ending this chapter with this one. And if you are not able to, please leave. Have belief in God. This is the message. This is the message. No. This is the message only. This is one of the thing Lencho believed in. Or bhi guesswork kar lo thoda sa. Harsimar, please. One should be grateful for what one have, and one should be grateful to others who help you also. Yes, what do you wanted to say, beta?